Are you still using auto white balance when filming your projects? I'm about to show you three reasons you should never use auto white balance. Every light source has a color temperature, and we're not talking about color light bulbs like those we use around the holidays. Color temperature refers to the hue or the color characteristic of the light emitted by a light source. Every light source has a unique color temperature, and it's measured in Kelvin. Anything below 5,000 Kelvin is considered warm color, and everything above 5,000 Kelvin is considered cool colors. White balance is the process of compensating for the color temperature of the light source captured by the lens. For example, daylight is very blue, so in order to accurately capture the colors, the camera will add the opposite color. In this case, the camera will add orange to balance for the extra blue generated by the sunlight. Without this process, the colors in our images would look completely off. In theory, regardless of the color temperature of your light source, whether warm or cool, if you set your white balance correctly, their shot should look identical. The white should be white and the color should be accurate. Now, one of these images I took using my light source set at 52K, and for the other, I set my light at 31K, and I simply adjusted my white balance so that they would match the light source I was using. Can you guess which one is which? I didn't do anything to these images. They're straight out of the camera. I just applied the Rec 709 LUT to them. Well, now you can see that this image was taken under the 52K light, and this one was shot under the 31K incandescent light bulb. Auto white balance tends to do a good job measuring the light source color temperature in order to balance the colors accurately. So why should you never use auto white balance? Number one, mixed lighting. Working in corporate film, the majority of my work is in uncontrollable environment and often in mixed lighting, just like the picture of this office. Now, this may not be an actual place that I filmed in, but I purchased this picture because it's a great representation of what many of us face on a regular basis. A lot of daylight mixed with a warm light source. Auto white balance will have a hard time finding the correct balance in mixed lighting conditions between adding orange to balance the outside temperature or adding blue to balance the inside. By using manual white balance, you can set your white balance by making sure your white card is flooded with a good mix of daylight and the warm office light. From there, you can simply dial your white balance up or down to reflect how you want to capture this environment. Once set, your white balance will stay consistent regardless of where you point your camera in that office. Number two, consistency. A few years ago, I got an incredible opportunity to work on a project in Kenya. I was able to hire and rent great equipment from a cinematographer in Nairobi, including a DJI Inspire 2 drone. While I didn't notice that his drone was set to auto white balance, I checked every settings before I took off except the white balance. My drone at home is always set to 56K. I only use it outside during the day, so I don't even think about white balance when I use a drone. I didn't do anything to these two shots. I just simply applied the Rec 709 LUT just so that you can see the difference. Those shots are literally back to back. This is shot 733 and this is shot 734. I literally captured those shots 6 minutes apart from each other and they're in the same location. So it's not like there was a huge change in lighting conditions. I took this shot and then I flew the drone above these trees and then I turned it around to face this direction. I spent a lot of time trying to color correct those shots in post-production when I got home, but no matter what I did, they never looked great. So this was a real bummer and a humbling experience to travel across the world to just make a simple mistake like having my white balance set to auto. Number three, creativity. White balance is more than a technical setting you need to adjust. It plays a big role in the creative process. If you're filming someone reading a book under a nice warm lamp, your shot should be warm where the light shines. But if your auto white balance identify your light sources as 32K and compensate by applying more blue to the image, you can lose all the warmth of your scene. In this case, you want your white balance to be higher than the color temperature of your warm light bulb so that the camera will add a little bit of orange to the image. Cinematography is an art, and we need to understand how to use the tools that we have in order to capture the shots we want, not hoping they'll turn out. So next time that you're out with your camera, experiment with your white balance and try to adjust it to get either a warmer tone or maybe a cool tint to your image. Now, thank you for watching this video until the end. As a token of my appreciation, I'd like to offer you my free camera setting cheat sheet. Just follow the link below to download the free cheat sheet. Thanks again, and happy filming.